special episode. It's a Throwback Thursday. Welcome to 1995. You know what? It's five going into six.
Yeah.
So let's have a look at some of your beeper messages that you've sent us. Because at that time there was no...
I had a beeper.
Of course, Anita Cheaper, InTouch Keeper.
You had a beeper?
Of course we had beepers. Look at our outfits.
Our voiceover money paid for beepers when we were 13.
All right, so voiceover one, voiceover two.
Yes.
So VO one, please can you read the beeper messages?
Thank you, Pabby. All right, so sends those. How would you like this read?
Can you be friendly, inviting, but also stern and disinviting?
I know who's gonna win the World Cup. To watch trending and say, hilarious. How about that? Oh wait, that's my own voice. I know who's gonna win the World Cup, and that gives me time to watch trending. Say, how about it?
Hey.
All right, Winnie Baloy says all. Family, how good is it?
Amazing.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Too many people. Okay, Menelisi Dlamini says, I'm very happy to spend my last hour of my birthday watching you guys. Happy birthday. That's one ab. One. Just one.
Well, we love everything you sent to us. Thank you very much, voiceover one. That was convincing, but
Thank you.
We need another take for the client.
All right.
All right, so I have to give you a quick mention about what's happening at Vits at the moment. Now, I'm sure all of you Vitsies know all about this. History is about to be made at one of the leading universities in the country, the University of the Witwatersrand, otherwise known as Vits University, has announced that they will have a black female chancellor. For the first time ever.
Wow.
The two running up candidates are both black females. One is a friend of our show, Dr. Judy Lamini, qualified doctor, accomplished businesswoman, sweetheart of note. And the other candidate is Dr. Anele Ngadi, who is a renowned strategist and specializes in economic development and financial management and laws. And by laws, I mean law. Now, we'd like to congratulate both of these phenomenal women. We look forward to the announcement. I think either way, this is a win for South Africa, without a doubt. So, woman power, no?
I love this jacket. Your love don't cost a thing. Diddly-diddly. Bim, bim, bim. Thing,
no,
thing.
Okay, as I do this, you cut
love
to Musa.
Don't cost a thing, 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 thing.
Oh, that outfit, Musa.
Right, time now for the update for the day, and the hashtag was childish me versus adult me. That popped up on the feeds over the past weekend, and she shared some examples of all the dreams that they had as kids and about what they'd like to be like as adults. But then life came in and showed them a zebra. Right, so this is the first one that came through, this one from Tulu saying, childish me versus adult me. Childish me, by the time I'm 25, I want to have two houses.
Yes.
With one being a holiday house, driving my own luxury car, and married. Adult me, fire, fire, flames, zebra, 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 ha, zebra, ha, ha. A fire. All right, another one here from Obercanism that says, childish me versus adult me. Childish me, I can't wait to grub. Adult me, deadlines, TV spoilers, laziness, no Wi-Fi. Hey, drama. Hey, no money. Fake friends.
I love how TV spoilers can ruin your day. Love that.
And then, of course, the last one is from Anda. That says, or Anda, rather. Childish me versus adult me. Childish me, my community is full of alcohol users. Adult me.
An alcohol user.
An alcohol user, yes. Consumers of alcoholic beverages. Now, the next tweet then quickly reminded people of how unpredictable life can really be. Childish me versus adult me. Childish me, I'm keeping my virginity for the one. Adult me.
No way. Keep your virginity. Be like me. Just wait for the one.
How?
Mary.
Listen, virginity is a state. Now, for some of you guys with the hashtag that was childish me versus adult me, it's 609. It's the same thing. Take a look at this. This one from TP Sitola that says childish me versus adult me. Childish me watches cartoons the entire day until I fall asleep. Adult me watches cartoons the entire day and throughout the night.
Yeah.
What a man or a woman, I'm not sure. Another one from Tsulu here saying childish me versus adult me. Childish me steals a piece of meat from the pot and prays that no one finds out.
Do it again.
An adult me say eats half the meat in the pot and still hope that no one notices. Now onto the next hashtag, of course. And this one had some beautiful nostalgic moments that we need to look at. And this one came through from also this past weekend. And it was hashtag what 2000s missed. That was trending on the timeline today. And this hashtag, of course, was dedicated to the things that young people born after the year 2000 would not really understand. Starting off with this one from Puti Matobela. And this is the tweet that made you go, shoo. When last?
Hell yeah.
It says, when 2000s, what 2000s missed? Getting love letters.
Yeah.
Guys, you used to cry into the love letter, just your tears said, I love you so
much. Can I tell you two quick stories? So I had a dude who went to a different school and he wrote me like a 6-page love letter. And each page he highlighted the edges and then he shaded the inside with the same color. And then once I was on an airplane and one of the airmen, whatever the guys are, I thought he was fly. So I wrote him a quick note and then I spritzed my perfume and I gave him my phone number and we dated for a multiple periods of time.
So you go on picking people on from flights. You are Mr. Sakai.
You can meet someone anywhere.
You and is it illegal to go around spraying perfume inside the aircraft?
I thought the guy broke
up. But my boyfriend is the airman host.
The airman host or the air pilot?
What? Anyway, I said quick stories and I told quick stories. You guys like it.
Enough is enough.
I'm picking up clients.
And speaking of writing all sorts of things, the AMA 2000 supposedly would never understand what people learned and loved about songs back then. Here's this tweet that came through from Dimple that said, what 2000s missed is having to write lyrics in your lyric book and having to rewind the song until you get the specific part of the song.
You did that?
Yeah. Or taping it off the radio and then so that you don't get the announcer's voice on the song.
Sitting there like this.
Yeah.
You know what mine was?
Mm-hmm.
Doom, doom, doom.
Oh.
I'll leave it there. Now, of course, a tweet that came through was Acid Sire and reminded people of how during the day we're all sweet, loving children that ate snacks and bought juice and had a good time. But at night, things change.
Speak for yourself.
Ha ha ha. Here's the tweet. What 2000s missed? A 90s kid in 3 frames. The first one, very innocent. Big time bubble gum that lasted 5 chews and then the flavor was gone. Then you'd have to dip it in sugar. And then in your, okay, let me leave that. And the next were those juices that came as a cell phone, and you'd be like, hello, mama, hello, baby. And the last, 12 o'clock tonight. Volume
Emmanuel.
Zero. And a blanket like this. Like, shh. And then the moment someone, you hear a click, switch off. We see you. Now, something else that a lot of people born in the late 90s and 2000s probably would have never heard of.
Oh,
is this
I watched
what 2000s missed? They missed this. Bob TV. Yes. Well, here's a short bit of history. Maputo Tswana was a part of the Northwest. And of course, the territory was under the old apartheid rules where black people were separated according to their mother tongue. Now, because of this, Maputo Tswana, which mostly had a lot of people that spoke Setswana, was the channel for them. And it was then called Bob Maputo Tswana TV.
Baby, Maputo Tswana.
Is it boo?
Yeah. Two more.
But it's okay. And I think it's so great that we got to tell a bit of that story.
Yeah.
Because Bop TV was really cool. They had Teeny Bop before I was a kiddie and before the channel that you were on as a kiddie. So they were really like the progressive in many ways. It was amazing. Yes. Well done, Bop TV.
Well done, Bop TV.
We love it. Anyways,
we didn't have Trans Guy TV though. But
so that is it for now. And I'm going to walk away.
Join us.
Thank
join
you,
us
ladies.
At the table.
Awesome.
I love this color. I think it's like really quite awesome to have all this color around the table. Anyway, thank you very much for sending all of your things and hashtags and things and etc. But I think in the spirit of throwbacks, let's look at another hashtag that popped up on the timelines earlier this week. It is hashtag 2018 so fart ought me.
Hey.
Oh, 2018 so far taught me.
Yeah.
Ah.
although fart is so funny. Okay. Some of these tweets hold a lot of valuable lessons, really life-changing lessons. Really, some people have learned lessons from these tweets. So, who? Come a little closer, people. Okay.
That close, please.
Oh, thank you. And learn a thing or two right here on Trending.
Zang zang. This is the first lesson, number one.
It says, 2018 so far told me, hey, not everything is as it seems. The duella. That is cruelty, that is meanness, that is hardcore. And we've all fallen victim to something that looks beautiful on the outside, yes, and then on the inside.
There's literally nothing worse than finding out that there's actually less meat than you expected.
No. Are you gonna cry? You wanna give us names or a name?
I'm very affected by what you said.
Thanks, wow.
Thank you so
Thanks,
much.
Friend, no worries.
Now, here's another one that happened. Do you remember the time that Abuti fill up the dome and Mama Panther had a tour?
Yes.
Wow.
Really?
Wait.
Let's look at the tweet first.
Okay.
So at the bottom, you can see Pearl talking about Ebony the horse that she was riding for a shoot, and then she fell off the horse. And then in true Mama Panther style, she got back on that horse and rode it till the wheels came off, because that is the spirit of woman power. Ah, doesn't Kaspa come and say, ha ha, you fell. What were you doing on a horse when as a black woman?
Wow.
Certain things should be left to white people, don't you think? That's what you get for Oogpa! Pa! Yekela is indoors by long by black girl magic.
A last line.
So lots of people then chimed in.
What are they saying?
Me, I'm Team Pearl, woman power, about date is finished. And also people were saying, how? No one even likes a dome anyway. Why would I go fill it? Anyway.
Unless you're the face of it, and then they. Never mind.
Anyway, it turned out to be a hoax. Mm. You see, these two people, Kaspa and Mama Pearl Tusi, were in a music video together, and they were just drumming up some publicity, and they got you all to keep their eyes on them.
Yeah, Lala, but you can drum up proper publicity without minimizing black people. There's no reason to say, oh no, you're a black person, what are you doing with a horse? I mean, come on.
But you know what's, but it's good that it opens up the conversation for people to go, yes, but no. You know, sometimes it's provocative.
It's provocative.
It's provocative.
No, it's not. Conversation.
Correct.
But because also, is that audience, is that where they are, their level?
They're woke. Woke is evolution.
Right. Guys, learning to not jump to conclusions. Conclusions is a great lesson indeed. Ukulombe Ngwenya learned a rather sneaky lesson in this year, 2018. Must join in. Uto unana, hashtag 2018 so far taught me to steal my roommate's boss and cook it as mincemeat. Wow, very, very clever, Lala. I think we've all been creative, like Labuti. But what Anele did to Lindo took the cup. Princess Lindo, unana, wrote this before she posted screen grabs of her conversation with her friend Masjongin. So I applied for an S-Pass this year, and for the past 5 months I thought I wasn't approved. Kanti, my best friend's been using the funds for herself. Wow. P.S. She also has NSFAS. Wow. Well, Lindo continued to post her friend's apology after she exposed her on Twitter. I'm sure Anele wishes she had only stolen Ivor's and not the vouchers. You are abantu
banzima. So is that the lesson? Heavy. When in doubt, steal Vors.
No.
The lesson is there's always less meat than advertised.
I'm going to steal the board.
Okay, cool. I'm going to throw us to ad break, because that's what I do here on Trending SA on SABC3. So make sure you tell us some of the lessons that you've learned throughout 2018 with the hashtag #ZaOn3. We'll be back in the 18 area after this.
So this sounds so big.